Hello, viewers. Considering the current global condition, most of us have quarantined ourselves. While this can help the virus from spreading, there are a few concerns. For starters, how long is it healthy to stay indoors? Is a month in quarantine safe? Are physical and psychological issues a possibility? We're talking all that and more. To understand how long a person can stay in quarantine, we need to begin from the top. What happens to your body? Several memes have circulated online with people joking that they can live for a lifetime inside of a room if they have food, water, and Netflix. Sorry to inform you, memers, but it's not that easy. If a person has a successful week in quarantine, they'll be thinking that they can do it for the rest of their lives. The truth is, you'll have to go out sometime. Think about it, you'll eventually run out of necessities, not only food, but other things as well. What about soap? What about hand sanitizer? Maybe body wash and deodorant? These are all things that run out before you know it. But there's more to the dangers of quarantine. Humans by nature are social creatures. Whether introverts or extroverts, we need some form of human contact. It's one of the things that creates a successful society. When you've isolated yourself, you're not socializing with folks. At least, you don't get to do so face to face. Social skills are acquired. If they're not polished over time, we begin to lose them. You may become overconscious and make social situations difficult for yourself. Before we continue, show us some love by hitting the subscribe button and the notification bell. That way, you won't miss out on any of our great bestie content. Now, back to our point. Many experts have linked quarantining with depression. Some have even suggested that being quarantined can bring on a loss of sleep. They may also show signs of accelerated cognitive decline, affecting their executive function. Apart from that, being in isolation can hurt a person's cardiovascular health as well. Hearing this for the first time certainly is scary. This brings forth the question, is it all bad? Well, no, not if you're utilizing this time. For example, if you're still working from home, you should be okay. Your mind is still set on an objective. Quarantine may also work if you have a hobby. This can be anything productive, even an innocent pastime, from playing a musical instrument to painting or writing. All of them have one or the other therapeutic effect on your mind. If you decide to pursue a skill during quarantine, you'll learn very fast. That can be very helpful for you psychologically. It can calm your nerves down and reduce the chances of depression. Apart from that, learning a new skill can slow cognitive decline. This doesn't mean that these activities will make up for the troubles you've gone through while in quarantine. You'll still face the mental and physical consequences of being in quarantine. This is a great time to turn our focus towards another important question. How long can a human being survive in quarantine? The answer is not that simple. It's not possible for everyone to live in quarantine. For the most part, it depends on the temperament of the person. Different people figure out different ways of coping during a time of stress. Let's go a little deeper into the matter with a hypothetical scenario. Imagine you're a freelancer who works from home. Since your life doesn't seem to be as happening as your peers, you're a little envious of them. But here's where you have an advantage. You are used to staying home and know what to do in situations like this. As a result, you'll prepare in advance. You'll keep track of your supplies and prepare yourself mentally for a quarantine period. You're also used to a degree of self-isolation. As a result, going without physical communication won't be as difficult. On top of that, since you're a freelancer, you'll still have to work. Yes, while the entire world will be in quarantine finding new activities, you'll still be active. However, you'll still need time to rest. This is essential for your brain. It's where a proper work-life balance comes in handy. Otherwise, your mental exhaustion will cause fatigue. Coronavirus isn't the only thing that can affect you during this time. Your lifestyle choices also have a huge impact. But enough on freelancers. Let's talk about those people who live with a 9-to-5. If you're among them, you may have a really hard time surviving. As exciting as it can be to occasionally stay home from the office, a routine quarantine can be downright depressing. If you're working from home, you have something to stay occupied. If you aren't, you'll have to find a hobby. One good thing about you is that you know how to keep your work and life separate. But since you're so used to working outside of the house, you probably won't be as prepared for this type of adjustment. You won't know how to manage it right away. You'll also struggle with figuring out how much food you would need during this quarantine period. You'll also miss the outdoors. Your brain will constantly seek external stimulation, but that doesn't mean you can't survive on your own. You currently can. When you miss your friends and family members, you can try to contact them. Perhaps a Facebook session is in order. There are also a lot of PC and Android games that you can play to keep yourself occupied. Since every human being is different, it's not possible for anyone to determine how long you'll survive in quarantine. But can we survive for a month? While surviving in quarantine for a prolonged period may be impossible, we would say that a short period like 1 month is feasible. Yes, you may experience some of the issues we outlined earlier, but they are possible to overcome. A small time frame like a month is ideal for anyone to pick up on a skill such as cooking, painting, or writing. Just make sure that you have the right amount of supplies. If you're in quarantine for 2 or 3 months, staying sane may not be easy. Remember, stocking up on your regular supplies will help in this situation. On top of that, we live in the age of the internet, so you'll have enough to keep yourself entertained. All of these things may fail to keep you interested for a long period of time, but for a month, they're good enough. On top of that, you'll be doing yourself and the rest of the world a favor by not going outside. Stopping the virus from spreading further is crucial to the health of the world. Let's all do our part. Are you currently quarantined? Has it been difficult for you? Let us know in the comments below. We'd love to hear from you.
Enjoyed this video? Hit like, share, and subscribe to Bestie. Wait! What kind of bestie would we be if we didn't tell you about our other awesome videos? Go ahead, choose the left or right video and enjoy.